250 million years ago, Yosemite's landscape was a peaceful coastal plain. Now the investigation moves to 100 million years ago. The land that would become Yosemite is in turmoil. Volcanoes dot the skyline, spilling mountains of lava onto the land. And entombed beneath 2 miles of volcanic rock lies Yosemite's molten granite. The next 10 million years is a critical period for the rocks of Yosemite. Something unique is happening to the granite, making it tough enough to hold up cliffs 3,000 feet high. The search for the secret of Yosemite granite's immense strength led scientists to the biggest steep-sided granite block in the world, the mighty El Capitan. Twice the height of the Empire State Building, over 3 billion cubic feet of rock rises into the air.
El Capitan is the largest granite monolith in Yosemite National Park. 3,000 feet of pure granite. It's one of the biggest cliffs in the world. When I look up at something like this, I really want to hang on to the rock because I feel like I'm going to fall backwards with vertigo. Amazing.
El Capitan is the ultimate big wall climb. Once considered impossible to conquer, it's a treacherous ascent up a vertical, near featureless rock face with only a handful of routes to the summit. Sheer granite walls are normally unstable and over time get pulled down by erosion. So it was a mystery how rocks could hold up cliffs this big. Scientists are sampling the rocks to find out, but the Yosemite granite doesn't give in without a fight.
Whew. These Yosemite granites are really hard. You can work up quite a sweat trying to collect a bag full of this stuff.
Buried within this rock is the secret to Yosemite granite's success.
Oh, finally. Well, one clue to why these rocks are so tough is given by this sample right here. These are really large crystals. Large crystals make a rock really strong. They kind of weld together and they're flawless and they give a rock a lot of strength.
But it was a mystery how these tough crystals got so large and created such flawless rocks. This is in contrast to normal granite, which, when it cools, forms a hard rock with a fatal flaw. Riddled with cracks, these rocks are vulnerable to erosion.
If you take anything and it's very hot and you cool it quickly, it'll shatter. And granite bodies that cool quickly form a lot of cracks that weaken the rock body and make it unable to support 3,000-foot cliffs. If you walk up to a typical granite and look at it, you'll find cracks a foot apart, 2 feet apart. You walk up to El Capitan, you might have to go 100 feet or more between cracks in the rock.
Clearly, something different happened here 100 million years ago.
El Capitan is really just one large, uniform, essentially faultless piece of granite, and that makes it very difficult for erosion to deal with.
For many years, it was a puzzle what had caused Yosemite granite to form so differently. But the secret had been staring scientists in the face.
One of the things you can see is a clue as to how this landscape formed in that dark diagonal splotch. That's called the North American Wall because that dark blob looks like, with some imagination, a map of North America, and you can kind of see Baja California sticking down on the left side there and Alaska up to the northwest. And it's made up of a much darker, finer grained rock like this.
This dark granite is not just a map of North America. It's a window into the unique events that happened inside the Yosemite granite when it was buried deep beneath the earth.
And it's a younger body of granitic rock that filled a crack within the main body of El Capitan granite.
100 million years ago, the main body of granite cools and begins to harden beneath the earth. But then fresh, molten rock invades a crack and injects it with a blast of heat. The granite now takes 10 times longer to cool. Huge, robust crystals form and reseal the defective cracks. Time after time, fresh molten rock invades old, remelting and welding the Yosemite granite, creating gigantic shatterproof blocks, which now tower thousands of feet into the air.